feeling butt slapping from that last run. Anyway, right now I'm heading from Elberta to at Soldier Pass. There's a shooting range there. If you take the road to the left, and if you take the road to the right, it actually kind of goes up into the mountains a little bit. There's a few camping spots. The last time I was up here is when I had my Jeep back in 2010. I have not been man enough to take any of my other low-profile cars up this road because it can get pretty hairy from time to time. It's not a fast road. It's not like an extreme off-road like Little Moab is. Might get a little more vibrations because my front hubs are locked right now. But I'm just going to go there. I'm going to try and find that Jeep trail. And it takes it around. It goes around to the south side of Eagle Mountain. Hopefully there's cell phone reception because I have my... What's in here? I'm not sure which one it's in. I found it. I found it. While I'm driving 60 miles an hour. Well, on a two-lane road that nobody takes, apparently. But this is a Landsea Air magnet mount. Because I can, you know, basically Landsea Air GPS module. They run about $30 on Amazon. And then it's, depending on the program that you want, will depend on how much you pay per month. So right now, the one I'm paying for is $25 a month. It's $24.99, pretty much even. They don't put taxes or anything on that. And it's 60-second increments. But these, once they're moving, they're always tracking. So the programming fee is what you're able to see on... I've got it on my phone as well. But on the computer, it's... and it's got to be somewhere where it can vibrate. Because that's actually their motion activated. So we're going to get up here... Soldier Summit. I've got that actually on my GPS maps already, or on my Google Maps. yards of cell service. So I'm just watching for a cutoff road that may or may not be on Google Maps. Thank you. lucky for me, the roads that I need to take to get out of here are marked on Google. So, with one bar of cell service, for LTE anyway, I obviously took too many roads up. And that one split off to go south. I need to keep going west. So, that was a fun road to go up though. But now we're on, I saw the gray road as I was going up this other road, and I'm like, oh, I wonder if I'm on the right road. Which I wasn't. So, there you go. There's a lot of red rock that's just sitting there, just in the middle of nowhere. I'm wondering if there was an old mine there. Probably. Doesn't look like there's any off-roads going to it, but it's on the far west side of these mountains, off this main road. Can't miss it. Unless you're colorblind, then you might, but this red rock. And it's not like it's an outcropping, it's a bunch of tailings, it looks like to me. There's a whole little off-road area here too. It kind of looks like a mini Moab. Mini little Moab. Kind of a cool little section. I don't think I remember seeing this. There's a couple of little off-road areas, but it's, yeah, like this. You'd have to come and see it. Kind of cool. I'll take some still shots. Once I get down to it.
sounds a lot like burnt gunpowder out here. There's tons of shells everywhere. Thank you.
Mountain. If you look up, zoom in, you can see, well, Lake Mountain. There's one trail that goes through on the south side of it. And it's car passable for the most part. But here is Elberta. This is Elberta right here. Highway that goes to Eureka, back to Payson, and that's the highway that goes up to Saratoga Springs. But you just go. This is the Soldier Pass open shooting range. Oh, that's it right there, but this is the open pass. You can take that, and you go left to go to the shooting range, you go right, or you stay on the straight path, and it takes you over the Jeep trails. And that's me backing up a ton, trying to figure out my directions. And to get any of these green arrows, I have to have a cell phone signal, so there's definitely cell phone all the way out here. So you go up the dirt road, it kind of just goes straight. Google Maps has it. And then, of course, there's a cutoff, and it says it's 1,000 north. That's a county street, but as you can see right at the end, there's actually a gate and it's locked, so I had to turn back and continue on that. But this road actually goes up. It looks like it goes into a private area where you're not supposed to be, but it's actually okay. It does have speed limit signs on it, so it's public. And then that's Eagle Mountain right here. So you just